Hello people, welcome to part 3 of tutorial for EVA foam. I may have said already that I wasn't going to do part 3 or didn't get any hint I was going to do this, but I thought to myself I would take this one step further and start showing you guys tips on painting EVA foam. So yes, I am going to show you more tips on EVA foam. This time we're going to go through priming the EVA foam, painting it, and then it will show you the finished look. So a few quick tips, and what you'll need is obviously the foam that you've been working on. You'll need a paintable surface. Obviously this is when you're priming it and when you're spray painting it. If you are spray painting it, you need a mask of some sorts. I will be spray painting, but at a later part I will get the masks required, but you will need a mask because most paints can be quite toxic, or fumes that are released when you use them. You'll also need something to prime the foam. So in this instance, because you're using EVA foam, I would recommend you get something that's not actually spray paint for this instance, because you'll find that in the foam there's actually little holes in it. I just happen to have some foam here. If you look at it really closely, you might see there's some small holes in it, and these crop up when you start painting it. So get something to prime these with, not spray paint. In this case, I will be using... I don't have it on me. Where is it? Here it is. EvoBond PVA. I'm going to be using this to prime my foam. It basically will help to fill in those holes, and it takes away the foamy kind of look when you're actually spray painting it. And you will want, if you're using this, you'll want to use several layers of this. Don't just use one, because when you add the paint, you'll find that the paint will start coming off. Okay? So get your primer, your spray paints, paintable surface, and your foam. That's what you need. Obviously, you'll need spray paint as well. Okay? And also, if you are spray painting, I do recommend you... I do recommend you get something to add to the top of the paint when you're done. So, what I'm using is Crystal Clear Rust Oleum. It is a protective coat, a gloss finish, and basically it will just add a surface tooth over the top that will help protect the paint, and it will stop it from peeling away. So also make sure you've got something to protect the top layer. One more thing. Obviously you're going to need the container to put the glue in, but you guys knew that, right? Oh, and you'll need a paintbrush as well for the paint, EVA paint thing. Yeah. Okay, as you can guys now see, I've got my foam with me now. This is going to be the chest plate for my Destiny. This is going to be the chest plate for my Destiny cosplay. It is a very simple build, you can easily remake it because the design is so simple. It's based, I'm going to be looking more at the painting techniques on this. I have my glue, and I am using the paintable surface of styrofoam boards because I don't actually need these, and also got the other parts that I'm using. So first thing we've got to do is have your container. So the container I am using is just a part of a milk carton. You don't need anything fancy, just something that you can stick the glue in. And I have my paintbrush. Word of advice, before you start using this kind of glue with the paintbrush, is that when you clean the paintbrush, you gotta get all the glue off, because if you don't, this is what happened before when I didn't clean mine. Now I'm just gonna show you guys how hard it is when this thing is actually solid. Because I did try to get glue off, Yeah, that's quite hard time banging it. This is me banging it on wood. Yeah? Yeah, you see that? I think I've made my point, but... Okay, so first thing I'm going to do, and it is probably stupid, because I do advise that you wear something on top of your clothes, so it's glue getting in your clothes, but I do trust myself not to do it, so I am going to risk it. It is very stupid, but yeah. So first thing we're going to do is we're going to get the glue, You don't want to pour too much in, because for this, I recommend, you know, if you have a carton similar to this, I only recommend you fill in about that much, really, because you'll find if you don't use it, you won't use that as much glue as you think, it'll be a bit of a waste. So we're going to pour it in. Make sure you don't do this near the edge, because that would be very stupid. So I'm going to pour some in now. Obviously, you want to pour in less rather than more, because you can obviously just pour in more after you've used up what you already have. So what I'm going to do with the chest plate is I'm just going to use light strokes, and you want to put on a thin layer. Don't spread it all on, because you can just take your time with this, and if you put too much on, it will just dribble. So I'm going to get a little bit of glue, make sure it's not dribbling, and I'm going to just spread this on thinly, right? Yes, it looks like a thin layer, but when you add these on eventually, it adds a nice paintable surface to it. So this is only going to be what I'm doing for a while, so I'll just put some music on for you guys now, and skip ahead if you feel you just want to see the results, okay? Now you can see that I've done the front part of the chest plate. Now the reason I haven't actually painted back with PVA is that when I lay it back, it just won't stick to the surface that it's laid on. So when I take it off, it won't actually take any foam off the back, and obviously that's not good. So I've only painted the front. Now you need to be patient with this, because the more patience you put into it, the more you'll get out of it. No brainer really, just follow it. So what I'm going to do is I will show you, I will start adding more tips as I'm painting this, but I will leave it here as the end of part one. At the beginning of part two, I will show you guys what it's like when the first layer has dried, and I will finish adding glue to it, and eventually we'll get down to the actual painting. So I'll see you in part two. I will do part two and edit it as when I can. But for now, keep checking my videos, like, comment and subscribe. And if you have any wishes for future videos, then please also comment those as well. Goodbye.